three rivers in Chennai, they're considered to be dead because all three are highly polluted. So we have sewage which flows directly into the river, and we have a lot of solid waste that's being dumped on the banks of the river. And I've heard stories from my mom and grandmom where they went on boat rides in the river and where they swam in the river. So there's still hope to clean the river and restore it.
Because it is out there in the river, powered by solar, it just continues every day treating the wastewater for 200 people. If you imagine this on a larger scale, you can see what a difference this can make to a polluted water body.
It's important to remember that the pollution process is incremental because it also reminds us that the restoration process is also incremental. And every little part of restoration that we achieve is a part of reversing that trend of degradation. And it can snowball on the restoration process just as things have snowballed in the contamination process in the past. And that's why the education and really doing strong technical interventions to prevent pollution, carry out bioremediation in situ, are so powerful and important, because they can empower and motivate the wider restoration process.
Preventing and intercepting the inflows of pollution, and restoring and planting of the river banks, and replanting and restoring of the watershed in general, and then bioremediating in situ in the waterway.
And by putting one of these out there in the water and demonstrating that we can actually draw in this pollution and treat it and discharge clean water back to the river, we're making a strong statement that we're standing up for the restoration of this water body, and it's not okay to put in more pollution, and that this one is on the path to recovery, you know, that it's not a lost cause anymore.